So let's get on with it. So I'll time this just to get an idea, a rough idea, not including the configure, which was negligible anyway. It's only a couple of seconds, and the install will probably only be 5 seconds or so. But yeah, we'll get a general idea of the compile time for the SBUs, which, as always say, are only a very rough guide. Right, so it's 1:20, so it's probably an SBU of almost 1.5 minutes. So we are on x86-64, so we should see some output from this command. That's what I'd expect. And yes, there it is there. So that proves that we are in a 64, or there's one bit of proof that we're in a 64-bit system. Okay, so that's the first phase of bin utils done. Once again, for 64-bit hosts, there's some changes that are made here, but there's no output. So we've got an SBU of 8.8, so it's going to be approximately 15 minutes to run this, so let's see what we actually get. Okay, so yeah, that took about 13 minutes, and it's roughly correct with the estimate. Let's install and move on. So that's the kernel headers done. Move on to glibc next. Right, so that's built in just under 7 minutes, so it's not too bad. Let's do some checks. Right, I haven't installed. Funny, I've just been reading about why, or looking at why Vim's not available, and it's because I didn't actually install it, just been looking at the video, so that is why I haven't got Vim available. So if I need it, I'm going to have to build it in the CLFS-3 environment and install it, but I'm hoping that I won't need it and that we'll get a Vim up in this environment. Oh, okay. What's this about? Oh, right, that's because I've just created this dummy .c. Okay. Right, let's have a look at all of them. So yeah, they've just been created, so I can delete them. And let's try the install again. Hopefully this hasn't messed anything up. Right, so that's done. Now let's run the tests. That's better. It's compiled properly this time. And the output is correct as well, so that's good. spin utils pass 2 should take just over 1 SBU. Okay, so yeah, it was just over 1 SBU, so let's install that and prepare for readjusting later on. Let's do GCC pass 2 next. Right, so it's compiled after 20 minutes. Let's do an install. And a symlink and another check. So that output looks good. Okay, I'm going to run the test because this is going to be used by the tests later on, especially for GCC and bin utils, just to get an idea of how it runs. But it does say there may be some failures. So there's no failures in that part. There's none there. Okay, so it looks like we didn't have any errors there, so that's good to know. Let's install that. Okay, and carry on. Again, I'm going to test this as it's part of the test. There was one error there. Segment violation. I actually didn't test this when I was running through similar tests before I started this video, and I did get a seg fault with bin utils test, so that's quite interesting. There's obviously something wrong with CLFS, which is, I guess, is probably why I'm always a bit wary about cross-compiling. I'd rather build on a natural hardware, so my guess is that's what's happened. We'll have to take it for what it is, and I hope it doesn't cause any further problems. In fact, let's have a look at expect. Yes, it's issued these seg faults here. That's interesting. Let's have a look at seg fault 18. Oh, at 18. Okay, doesn't seem to be anything specific for this particular error. Let's try a Google search if that brings up anything better. Okay, that's not very helpful. I know the RAM's good in this machine. I have tested it recently, unless it's suddenly gone wrong. Okay, there's nothing particular there about what it means, so I just have to carry on. Hopefully building this Linux and then the final one will actually get rid of it as a problem. But there does seem to be something inherently wrong with this CLFS build. But like I say, I've built CLFS a handful of times before, and I always get the impression there's always something not quite right. And due to lack of knowledge, I can't put my finger on what it is exactly. So that at least looks fine. Okay, So these commands are going to be used quite a lot, same commands, so I'm just going to stick these all together and then recall the command when I say it, save me doing some typing. Okay, so we've got to change ownership. So everything now, from now on, is done as root. So I've got to check the LFS variable is set. And that's about keeping the tools.